Hello everybody and welcome back to another Strange Voodoo TV video. I'm Buddy Strange, this is Strange Voodoo TV, and how are you doing everybody? Happy Thanksgiving. I hope you are just stuffing your face right now and enjoying yourself some Buddy Strange as you're enjoying yourself a great Thanksgiving. But if not, if you are catching this later, I hope you are enjoying some of your leftovers. One of my favorite things to do is take some turkey, slather some Miracle Whip on some bread, and just throw that turkey down, make yourself a sandwich, and eat it up. I also like to, I know this may be weird, but throw some cranberries on there as well, but that's just me. Anyway, I've got something special for you guys today in Madden 19. No, it's not going to be your average, just everyday Madden 19 video, and no, I'm not going to be rebuilding a team today. Instead, we're going to be taking already built team, hand-customized myself, along with the help of some community files, by the way. But anyway, besides all that, I'm going to show you these rosters and reveal the surprise there. Let's get into it. SVTV's Thanksgiving special is now underway. All right, everybody, here is the deal. We are going to be doing the all-time Cowboys roster, but that is not it. That is not all. We do not stop there. We go forward here on SVTV. We do not stop at that. We do not stop at greatness. We stop at legendary, and here we are going further than this, and we are adding the all-time Lions roster. Yes, the two teams that always play on Thanksgiving. When you say Thanksgiving, you automatically think Lions and Cowboys football, and here today we are going to be playing two games. Yes, count them, two games. We're going to be playing one as the Lions versus the Cowboys, and then we are going to switch it up and play Cowboys versus the Lions, and that is going to be the special today. So let's go through these rosters and see who we have to play with. First off, for the all-time Lions roster, we've got the great himself, Bobby Lane, the guy who cursed the Lions for 50 years and probably tacked on a couple more, because holy shit, they are not good still. They've gotten better, but yeah. Interesting fact, the 50th year that they were supposedly cursed, that was the year that they went 0-16, if you didn't know that. Yeah, Bobby Lane got traded to the Steelers, and I might do a video on it because there was actually a lot of stuff that just changed the NFL forever just from that one trade alone. Watch out for a video on that. We've got the guy who supposedly had to break the curse, Matthew Stafford himself, probably the second best Lions quarterback ever. Based on talent, maybe the first, but yeah, you got these two legends of Detroit on the roster. That's pretty good. Halfback, we got, this was the easiest to pick. We got Barry Sanders, Doak Walker, the running back who has an award named after him in college, the Doak Walker Award, of course, and Billy Sims himself. So yeah, you got these three just monsters. You know what? Up until recently, the Lions have actually had a really good running back history, very underrated. It's not just Barry Sanders. Billy Sims was a beast too. Doak Walker was really good in his day, and they've had even more really good running back talent come out and play for him over the years, but these are the three that are going to be playing for us today and against us today, so eesh. Cowboys defense better get ready. All right, fullback, we couldn't put his full name in. That is not a misspelling, but it's going to be Corey Schlesinger, the guy who led blocked for Barry Sanders for most of his career, the guy that took a lot of Barry Sanders' touchdowns because the Lions didn't want to run Barry on the goal line for some stupid reason, but anyway, enough of that. Corey Schlesinger, very well deserving for one of the best fullbacks, if not the best fullback. My personal favorite Lions fullback, so he's going to get the all-time greatest Lions fullback award right here. All right, wide receivers group, probably the second just obvious picks besides running backs and maybe quarterbacks, but anyway, Calvin Johnson, are you kidding me? The greatest Lions wide receiver of all time. The second greatest Lions wide receiver of all time, Herman Moore. I hope you guys know Herman Moore. He's a personal favorite just as a player in general, not even just as a Lion, just as a player in general. He's one of my favorite players ever. Very underrated wide receiver. Really, really solid, awesome wide receiver in the 90s, and definitely deserving of the second spot on the Lions' all-time greatest wide receivers list. Brett Perryman. Yes, Breshad Perryman's dad was a Lion, and he was actually really good for the Lions, especially in that 95 run with Scott Mitchell, Barry Sanders, Herman more. All that, all those guys. One of their best seasons since Bobby Lane left and left the curse on him was 95, and he was a big part of that season. Yes, we've got the short-lived Lion wide receiver Golden Tate before he went to the Eagles. He actually put up really good numbers well on the Lions, and I thought he kind of deserved a spot on the Lions roster here. This one definitely could be argued for me, but I thought he deserved to be on the list. And then you've got the return specialist, Mel Gray, just absolute beast in the return game while he was with the Lions. And yeah, he deserves to be on this list. If just for return alone, he deserves to be on the list. All right, tight ends. We've got Charlie Sanders, Hall of Famer, beast, tight end back in the day. Could catch pretty much anything. And yeah, he's definitely the top tight end in Lions history. And then you've got Cloyce Box, who, if you haven't heard of Cloyce Box, are you kidding me? No, I'm joking. I knew of Cloyce Box, but not that much until I started reading up on him for this, looking for any second tight end to just put on the Lions roster. He was actually a beast. He actually played halfback a little bit, but he just played at the end position back then when they just called it end, not even tight end. But yeah, he was apparently, like, he's really skinny of a guy, 6'4", 220, and yeah, that's Cloyce Box. He didn't even wear a face mask, people. Are you kidding me? That's how tough this guy was due to the times. Yeah, his stats are pretty good. Look him up, everybody. Very good tight end. And for offensive linemen, we've got Lomas Brown. Are you kidding me? Yes, very good left tackle for Detroit. Would have been a good left tackle for anybody. And then you've got legendary Detroit Lion Jeff Back is coming in and backing him up. We are looking really good at left tackle for sure. I mean, if this was a rebuild, I'd be super excited. At the left guard position, because they are lacking at interior alignment just a little bit, we've got Kevin Glover, who was actually a center for most of his career, but we're moving him to guard because he also kind of played guard a little bit throughout his career, but he was mostly a center. We're moving him to left guard because we need a little bit of help out there. And then we have Eric Andelsek, who I will admittedly never heard of, but he was on the list of greatest Lions players on the rankings. Yeah, I've never heard of him myself, I'll be totally honest with you, but I'll take the rankings word for it, the Lions to Kevin Glover. All right, at center, we have Dominic Raiola, who, if you don't know, was a very dirty player, but was a very good player. He was probably one of the best interior offensive linemen for the Lions, probably in Lions history. That is why he is the starting center, only passing up by 1 point. Alex, what a shits. We're just gonna say whoa cheese whiz, but that guy right there, however you say his name, if you want to take a shot at it, please, by all means, take a shot at it. But we have him backing up Dominic Raiola again. I have no idea who this guy is, but he was on the top Lions list. He was kind of low, but he was on it, and I'll take the Lions fans' word for it again. All right, at right guard, we have Dick Stanful, and yeah, I could not find for the life of me another interior lineman, and TJ Lang has been really good just in general over his career, and he's on the Lions, and we decided to let him stick around and back up Dick Stanful, who will be starting the whole time, hopefully, and very deserving. I do know him, and he was really good throughout his career, very deserving of this starting right guard position. All right, right tackle, we have Luke Kuechmer, and probably one of the best offensive linemen of all time, certainly in the top 20, and very deserving of this position on the line. Backing him up will be Taylor Decker. Again, couldn't find another offensive lineman, but Taylor Decker has been playing lights out for the Lions recently since he's been drafted 2-3 years ago. Besides having an injury, he's been playing really good outside of that, and I decided to give him the spot since there was no one else I could fill it. Now, starting on defense, we've got Robert Porcher, however you want to say it. He's one of my favorites. I really enjoyed, I used to get him in the old Maddens. I used to pick him up out of free agency because he was old, but he was good, and he was always in free agency, so I used to pick him up. And if he was on a team, I'd trade for him sometimes, but you got him right here. One of the best defensive ends in Lions history, definitely has to be on this team. Backing him up is Doug English, and he was really good with the Lions as well, very deserving. Not as deserving, but deserving nonetheless, and he is going to be backing up Robert Porcher. All right, at the other defensive end position, we have Al Baker and Ezekiel Ansah. Are you kidding me? I'm not kidding you. We have Ezekiel Ansah and Al Baker. Not bad. Not bad for the end positions. Let's see how the rest of this defensive line looks. Oh, yeah, baby. We've got probably maybe one of the best defensive tackle groupings of any team ever, stacking them up with each other. Here, we've got Alex Karras, Ndamukong Suh, Roger Brown, and that's not including Sean Rogers and a couple others that could easily be on this list, but we're gonna have it be these three, and yeah, that's this defensive line. Are you kidding me? With Robert Porcher, Al Baker, Ndamukong Suh, and Alex Karras. Oh my lord, we're gonna have ourselves a day. Although the Cowboys offensive line is pretty scary themselves. Of course, you've got 50 years of good offensive line play from the Cowboys, so it's gonna be tough. It's gonna be tough. Left outside linebacker, we've got Joe Schmidt, was a manimal in his day, and DeAndre Levy, more current, actually played middle linebacker, but we had to shift him out because apparently in Lions history they have no outside linebackers that besides Joe Schmidt and Wayne Walker, who you'll see in a second. Yes, he made the team. But anyway, middle linebacker, we've got just a total beast, total manimal, just amazing. If you don't know Chris Spielman, just look up some highlights. This guy played out of his mind every play, gave 110 maximum effort every time. Chris Spielman, and a really good story too. I think he has a football life. Go check it out. It's worth a watch for sure. And backing him up will be Steven or Stefan Tolick. I always said Stefan Tolick, but it's however you want to say it. People say any which way they want to. It's all about preference. Tornado, you know, tomato, titties. Anyway, shout out to Mitchell Trubisky. Anyway, Ernie Sims will be the third middle linebacker on this on this team. And yeah, I thought he had it. Even though he came out and said that he hated playing for the Lions later in his career when he went to, I believe, the Eagles or somewhere, we can't understate his importance to the Lions team, and I think he deserves to be on the team. All right, and as we said earlier, we've got Wayne Walker, and backing him up, Stephen Boyd. And backing him up, Stephen Boyd. Two very competent linebackers. Only one of them is an official outside linebacker. Stephen Boyd was actually a middle linebacker who we had to shift out, but Wayne Walker was actually a very, very good coverage linebacker. I actually didn't know that until I was looking him up and looking up his stats and everything. Jeez, that guy, he was really good. But anyway, that's the linebacking core. Let's get to defensive backs and see who we got. Oh yeah, baby. And I know what you're saying. Yay. Hey, buddy. He played most of his career with the Rams. What are you doing? He had his best years with the Rams. All that. I hear you. I understand. But I'm trying to, A, make this fun, make this awesome, and B, he had 20 fucking interceptions with the Lions. Are you kidding me? He played 4 years with them and had 20 interceptions. You know what? That's more than most people get in their career. Seriously. And he got it in 4 years late in his career. And remember, he started late because he went into the Army and it took him a while. He had to try out for the Rams to even get on there. And late in his career, past his 30s, he went to the Lions and just balled out, got himself 20 interceptions. I think he's more than deserving to be on this list. Bingo, there he is. Backing him up is Lynn Barney, who's, are you kidding me, definitely deserves to be on this list. Dick LeBeau himself, who, if you didn't know, yes, he did play. And yes, he was very good. And he transferred all that to his coaching career. And Hall of Famer Dick LeBeau has to be. There is no way he couldn't be on here. There he is. Dick LeBeau himself, the defensive genius, is going to help us and possibly hurt us when we play as the Cowboys. All right, backing him up is Darius Slay Jr., who he has to be on the list. I mean, yes, I know he's current and everything, but you can't understate his importance to that Lions team. He's been one of the best Lions cornerbacks in a while, in a long time, and definitely deserving to be on the team. All right, and then we have Jim David, and I will be the first to tell you I didn't know him either. And if you know him, props to you, great job. But he was, again, on one of the Lions top lists, and I had to include him. I looked up his stats, and yeah, he's deserving to take up the last spot on the cornerbacks depth chart, buddy. he is deserving, and we got him on the team. So great cornerback group, definitely rivals the Cowboys cornerback group, who you see in a couple minutes. Both of them have top tier names with people backing them up that are just crazy good themselves. So yeah, it's gonna be a fight for sure. All right, and deep in that defensive backfield, we've got Yale Larry. This guy was an all-purpose just player. I mean, played defensive back, played, he was a punter. This guy played everywhere on the field and was amazing at it. He was pretty much all pro in every position that he played, and he could play any position. He played linebacker at one point. Like, this guy played, and this guy hit, and this guy could kick. Very impressive. You'll see him again here in a second. Glover Quinn will be backing him up. Can't understate his importance, and he's more current. There's nothing wrong with being current as long as you are good, and this guy has been pretty much underrated as a Lions defensive back. Very good in his time with Detroit. All right, at strong safety, we have Jack Christensen, who, yeah, that boy could hit as well. He was very good with the Lions, and backing him up is going to be Benny Blades. It was really good for the Lions as well. Played most of his career with the Lions. I think he got 1 year with Seattle there at the end, but he was a very special player for Detroit. One of the hearts and souls of that 90s team, Benny Blades, just has to be on this list, and he will be backing up probably the best strong safety in Detroit Lions history, Jack Christensen. All right, at kicker, it was either Matt Prater or Jason Hansen, but Matt Prater deserves to be on the Broncos all-time list, in my opinion, not the Lions all-time list. Jason Hansen, on the other hand, had one of the best careers Lions kicker has ever had. Definitely deserving to be on the list. It would be a travesty not to have him on the team. I believe he had to be on the team, so I put him on the team. He'll put the team on his back, and I have no doubt that he might be instrumental in getting us a win when we were playing with the Lions. All right, and I told you you'd see him again. Yale Larry, he's probably the best punter in Detroit Lions history. He's not going to be able to wear 28. Of course, you can't put multiple numbers on multiple guys, but you'll see him as 8 at punter. He just goes to the sideline and, you know, switches out his jersey for some odd reason. It's NFL rules. You know, Goodell sucks. We all know that. So you can just pin it on Goodell being an asshole. But anyway, yeah, that is going to be the Lions all-time team. And really quickly, in the comments below, tell me whether you agree, disagree. What would you change about this Lions team? Who would you have different? Who would you not have? Just anything. Put it down below. I'd love to hear your opinion on this Lions team and what you think of it. All right, let's check out this Cowboys team, and then let's go play us a game, everybody. The all-time Thanksgiving extravaganza bowl is what we're going to call it. Let's check out this Cowboys team. All right, at quarterback, we have probably the best selection possible. We have Roger Staubach, Tony Romo, one of the best commentators ever, and Troy Aikman. Just that is a really good quarterback group, to be honest. The Cowboys have been very lucky over the years with getting quarterbacks. Yes, that includes you, Quincy Carter. Anyway, let's check out these running backs. Running backs, just absolutely, yeah. Emmitt Smith, Tony Dorsett, Marion Barber, just excellent running back group. I'm sorry, people who wanted Herschel Walker. I thought about it. I almost did it, but I think Marion Barber was more instrumental in your history, and also DeMarco Murray, but he was just too much of a flash in the pan for the Cowboys for me to pick. And then even Ezekiel Elliott, I get it. When I do this Thanksgiving special, if I do it again in a couple of years, yeah, Ezekiel Elliott's definitely going to be on here and probably push Marion Barber off or just get at it himself and keep four backs. But right now, I think it's Marion Barber, Tony Dorsett, Emmitt Smith, and just tell me what you think on that. All right, fullback, you know it had to be Darryl Johnson. Are you kidding me? You knew it. You knew it. I knew it. Everyone knows it. It has to be Darryl Johnson. Best Cowboys fullback. Blocking for Emmitt Smith in the 90s. Just, yeah. He did the dirty work, and he did it well. Definitely had to be on the team. All right, at wide receiver, Mr. Popcorn Man himself. We've got Terrell Owens. Mr. That's My Quarterback. Terrell Owens. He had to be on the Cowboys. Michael Irvin coming in. Duh. And then behind him in the slot will be Bob Hayes, one of the fastest, and I mean fastest, men ever to walk this earth or run this earth. I bet he walked pretty fast too. Anyway, one of the fastest men in football. Drew Pearson, known for playing with Roger Staubach and being part of one of the first Hail Marys ever, or I guess the first technical Hail Mary ever. Drew Pearson and that play against the Vikings. Everyone knows that, and if you don't know it, YouTube it.
So now we go to a second and 10. He is going to close. Drew Pearson. He got it. Touchdown.
It's a very important to NFL history, and Drew Pearson was the receiver, really good Cowboys wide receiver, and very deserving to be on this team. Behind him, yes, we decided to include Dez Bryant. I felt like he had to be on the list. Same with Cole Beasley. I mean, it's not like they were the best to ever play on the Cowboys, but I think they're just so synonymous with the Cowboys history and definitely had to be on the team just based on name value and Cowboy lore. Alone, Cole Beasley and Dez Bryant had to be on the team. That may just be me. If there's a Cowboys fan watching, please tell me in the comments below what you think on this. As far as tight ends go, you have one of the best tight ends in history. Jason Witten had to be on here. I mean, and then we got Jay Novacek. I mean, as far as Cowboy tight ends go, those are the main two. They had to be on here. All right, and now for maybe one of the best offensive lines in NFL history. I mean, just if you combine all of them, which we're doing here, probably if not the best, one of the best ever. I mean, geez. We've got Tyron Smith backing him up as Flozell Adams. Like, come on. That's crazy. Left guard, we've got Larry Allen. Jesus, that guy was a manimal. Just a walking tank. Just crazy. Backing him up as Mark Tunay. And yeah, are you kidding me? This guy was a monster in the 90s for the Great Wall of Dallas. And then at center, we've got Travis Frederick. And then another Great Wall of Dallas lineman, Mark Stepnoski. And it's just so good. Even the depth is crazy amazing. At right guard, we've got Zach Martin and Nate Newton. And this was tough for me. I kind of wanted to go Nate Newton over Zach Martin. But I don't know. I think when it's all said and done, Zach Martin will be one of the best Cowboys offensive linemen in history, and yes, I think he'll be better than Nate Newton. I think he already is better than Nate Newton, just the same strength and blocking ability, but a little bit more agile, because that's the way the NFL is today. But tell me, Cowboys fans, if you're, or NFL fans in general, just anybody out there, tell me what you think on this one as well. I'm very interested to see what you guys think. Nate Newton or Zach Martin, I'm interested in your opinion on this. All right, at right tackle, we've got Rayfield Wright and Eric Williams. Just very deserving, more than deserving. And that is a great way to top off this just dominant line. When I'm playing with this Cowboys team, better get some yards. And when we're playing against them, that's going to be a little scary. Even with the defensive line that the Lions have, woo, this is going to be a challenge. Now, starting on defense, we've got Ed Too Tall Jones. And yes, I had to add the too tall in there. you just have to. It's like a requirement. It's like Mean Joe Green. You have to have it in there. But anyway, Ed Too Tall Jones, DeMarcus Lawrence backing him up. And that is a pretty good start to this Cowboys defense. At right end, we've got Harvey Martin and Jim Jeffcoat. Yeah, that's really good as well. Harvey Martin was instrumental back in the day and helping the Cowboys get to some Super Bowls. Really big part coming off that end. And yeah, has to be on the team. Defensive tackle. Whew. I mean, I know I raved about the Lions defensive tackles, but Lord have mercy on the Lions interior offensive linemen who aren't that good comparatively. But Bob Lilly, Randy White, and Russell Maryland. Oh my God, this defensive line is absolutely absolutely terrifying. I'm just glad we have Barry Sanders. That's all I'm going to say right now. At least we have Barry Sanders. Hopefully he can do something for us when we're playing with the Lions. All right, outside linebacker, left outside linebacker, we've got DeMarcus Ware, Chuck Howley. Chuck Howley got himself a Super Bowl MVP. If you didn't know that, yes, he is in the NFL record books. DeMarcus Ware, probably the best outside linebacker in Cowboys history. And yes, that is even including Chuck Howley, Hollywood Henderson, and all of them. I had to go with DeMarcus Ware here, and I would imagine you Cowboys fans agree on that one. If not, again, comment down below. But yeah, DeMarcus Ware, Chuck Howley, that's really good. All right, at middle linebacker, we've got Leroy G. Jordan.
Ready, guys?
Let's do this. Leroy Jenkins!
And Hollywood Henderson. He was actually an outside linebacker. We kind of moved him in inside because, surprisingly, the middle linebacking core for the Dallas Cowboys has not been historically that fantastic outside of Leroy Jordan here. So we moved Hollywood Henderson, whose measurables and style kind of fit inside anyway. But yeah, Hollywood Henderson, if you don't know him, he used to wear sunglasses. I mean, even in the film room.
Tom, ever since I've known you, you've always been very low-key, very cool, very laid-back. Are you really serious about all this Hollywood stuff?
Oh, no, Janice.
In a dark film room, he'd wear sunglasses, and this guy, he was just a character. Hollywood is not his first name. That was the name given to him by players and coaches, and yeah, there is definitely a reason for that. He was definitely a character. Look him up if you don't know him. I believe there's a Football Life on him as well. All right, right outside linebacker, I may have misspoken with DeMarcus Ware, but I think Charles Haley was more of an influence on the 49ers. However, do not underestimate Charles Haley as a Dallas Cowboy, helping them in the 90s get the Super Bowls, get over that hump, finally start winning Super Bowls with the Cowboys. There is a reason this guy has 5 Super Bowls in his career, 2 with the 49ers, 3 with the Cowboys. It's because this guy was absolutely just terrifying off the edge. Really good, just sack master. Are you kidding me? Charles Haley finally getting himself into the Hall of Fame. Definitely deserving of that. Yes, he had some issues when he was playing, but thankfully he got those resolved, and he's just awesome. And we have him here on the Cowboys at right outside linebacker. Backing him up is legendary Cowboy Sean Lee, who just definitely deserves to be on the list. I mean, I know he gets injured a lot, but when he's not injured, this guy, if this guy was never injured, if he played his whole career just straight through, he might be the best Dallas Cowboy of all time. Like, seriously, he may have been the best Cowboy of all time, but he got kind of derailed and just eh. But that being said, he has come back time and time again and proved his worth, and that is why he is still a Cowboy. That is why he is on this team right now. He's in Cowboys lore as one of the best to play at his position. Yeah, just had to give it to him. So this linebacking core is pretty damn scary. You've got two of the best outside presences at linebacker, and whew, ouch. That front seven is looking really good. Let's see how the back half looks. Oh, that's how it looks. Are you kidding me? Jeez. Deion Sanders, Mel Renfro, Everson Walls, Larry Brown. Yes, the Super Bowl All-Star Larry Brown, a guy who did nothing after Larry Brown. Yeah. Deion Sanders, prime time, anytime. Deion Sanders, well, anytime's more Devin Hester, but prime. He was prime time all the time. Let's just say that. Even when he was playing baseball, this guy was prime time. Mel Renfro cannot be understated, his importance to the Cowboys history. Very, very good cornerback. And yeah, this is looking pretty good. Free safety, Cliff Harris, Bill Bates. Yeah, looking good. Strong safety, Charlie Waters and Darren Woodson. Like, this defense is just looking like no one can get past this defense. I don't see a weak spot anywhere on this defense. That's going to be tough trying to face that. But I'm glad in one game that we have that kind of defense, especially to stop Barry Sanders and Calvin Johnson. We're going to need all we can get to stop that duo. And we're getting all we can out of this group. That's for sure. All right, kicker Dan Bailey, one of the most accurate kickers of all time. Probably the best kicker in Cowboys history. Got let go this past offseason. Went to the Vikings and is having himself a pretty good season outside of a couple kicks. But anyway, Dan Bailey, yeah, had to be here. And then punter Matt McBrier, Australian-born punter, and definitely had to be on this team. Very deserving. He could kick the ball. It was very obvious he was not from here. He was from a soccer playing country, and he used that ability to the best of his ability, and it showed. Yes, Matt McBryer is the punter. All right, everybody. Those are the two teams. That's what we're working with. Let's get into these games. I'm going to play each team. The goal is to just score as many points as possible. Yes, we're trying to have fun with this. So yes, we're going to be playing arcade mode, not simulation. Just playing arcade mode, trying to have the most fun as possible, trying to score as much as possible on two great defenses with two great offenses. So yeah, let's get into these games. I'm going to be playing as the Lions first. Let's start this special Thanksgiving extravaganza bowl right now. All right, everybody, as we load this game up, I just want to say that we are going to be playing 8-minute quarters, and just to make it a little fun, I'm going to switch some players at halftime, mainly the quarterbacks, but I want to, instead of playing with just a couple of these people, I want to see what it's like to play with most of them, if not every one of them, and see what we can do. And one more thing, I do have a goal for points for both teams. I want to try to score 70 points for each game. That would be 10 touchdowns, and that would be pretty cool. I was gonna see about doing like as many points as there is years that these two teams have played on Thanksgiving, which would be from the Cowboys, who started in 66, not the team, but playing on Thanksgiving. That would be 52 points, and I was like, I can do better than that. 52 points, come on. We're first gonna try for 52, and then we're gonna try for 70. Maybe pretty difficult, to be honest, but we're gonna try for it. And as you can see, we have the Lions in Honolulu blue. That's their best jersey. They should have definitely kept that jersey. I mean, their jerseys right now are pretty cool, but I just like these classics more. And as you can see, the Cowboys are gonna have their alternate uniform, and I think that's like a really slick uniform, so we had to have that as their uniform. Let's get this game underway. We've got Dan Bailey kicking it off to Mel Gray. We are gonna be the Lions. Let's play this game. Everyone is hyped for this Thanksgiving matchup. We have it as the Super Bowl, but it's gonna be Thanksgiving Extravaganza Bowl. Mel Gray. Oh, showing some moves. Okay. We got stopped at the 23. Let's get on offense. I think the only thing that would make this game better was if Tony Romo was calling it. Ah, shoot. That didn't work out. Tony Romo and Jim Nantz, that's one of the best duos. What do you guys think? Who's your favorite duo in commentating right now? Joe Buck, Troy Aikman combo? Is that it? Dan Fouts or an Ian Eagle or somebody? Al Michaels, Chris Collinsworth? Just comment it down below. Who is your favorite duo in the booth right now? Mine would be Tony Romo and Jim Nantz. I think they're really good. Tony Romo has the chance to be one of the best ever, if not the best ever. He is certainly well on his way. I really enjoy him. Right there. To Golden Tate. Come on. Moving the chains against this great Cowboys defense. Holy crap. That's not Leroy Jordan. Okay. Why did they have DeMarcus Lawrence in the defensive backfield there for that graphic? That's kind of funny. All right. Come on, Madden. Get your shit together. Bobby Lane dropping back. Rolling to his right. Bobby Lane fires downfield to Golden Tate. Touchdown, Lions. Over Bill Bates and Cliff Harris. Oh, man. Golden Tate with the hands that Calvin Johnson did not have. Bobby Lane rolling to his right and just firing a laser to Golden Tate for the touchdown. Oh, man. That was perfect. Well, that's a good way to start the game. All right. Up 7-0 on a great, legendary Cowboys team. Let's get on defense and let's stop Roger Staubach and Emmett Smith. Oh, Lord. Terrell Owens. Michael Irvin. Oh, this is going to be hard. All right, we are on defense now. Oh, man. I just remembered that they have a great offensive line, too. It's not just their weapons. Ah, this is going to be difficult. Oh, come on. Get him down. Okay. Well, we're on the subject of all-time Cowboy greats going into the commentating booth. What do you think about Jason Witten's career so far? Yeah, oh, come on. Get him down. All right. Anyway, what do you think about his career so far? But what do you think about Jason Witt on Monday Night Football? I'd love to know your opinion on that. Him and Joe Pelosoro, I think, and old Booger McFarlane. Oh, pick it off. Are you kidding me? Tony Dorsett. Oh, come on. Come on, everybody. Damn. I can't be doing that. Come on, get in there. Get in there. Come on. Come on. No, but what I was saying on Monday Night Football, yes, Monday night, the Monday Night Chiefs-Rams game was legendary in its own right, but if that was called by, like, Al Michaels. Oh, come on. Get on that. That was called by, like, Al Michaels and John Madden. That could have been, like, legendary tenfold. I mean, no offense. Could you imagine just John Madden calling that with Pat Summerall or something? That would be sick. Oh, come on. All right, we're going to send a blitzer. We're going to send old Spielman. Spielman's got it. Spielman's got it. Come on, Spielman. Come on. Are you kidding me? Oh, I got the first down. Ah, oh, dick. Look at that. Like, what was that? He, like, spun out my player and then just laid on his back on Night Train Lane. What was that? Ah, oh, come on. All right, goal line stand right here. We do not have the defense built for a goal line stand, but we're going to do it. Points right there. Spielman! Oh, no! Spielman was right on him. That hurts. Let's get the ball back and run Barry Sanders. What do you guys say? All right, we are on offense, and we are going to run ourselves, Barry Sanders. I can't wait to do this. Oh, come on, Barry. Come on, Barry. Oh, right there. 3 yards. All right, we got ourselves another run with Barry Sanders. I'm surprised I didn't do the whole first drive with Barry. Oh, come on, Barry. Come on, Barry. Come on, Barry. All right, Barry, throwing on 14 yards there. Man, he just feels good to run with. He just, oh, man. I love Barry Sanders, just his highlight tapes. I could watch him all day. Should we check out Charlie Sanders? Johnson going right down the middle, maybe? Oh, we're going Sanders. Sanders has got it. Come on, Sanders. First down. Moving the chains. Good job, Charlie. I like Johnson on the comeback route. It has potential. And Bobby Lynn, what are you doing there, buddy? Damn it, Bobby. Golden Tate's been solid for us. Do we go him? Bobby Lynn. Run it. Block for me. Block for me, Tate. Good job, Tate. Good job. First down. Good job, Bobby Lynn. Oh, that was a great block by Golden Tate right there. Come on, Barry. I believe in you, Barry. I believe in you, Barry. Barry, 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 Barry. Calvin, why didn't you pick up your block there, bud? All right. Sanders on a dump-off screen. This could be dangerous. This could be dangerous. Oh, it's going to be dangerous. Touchdown, baby. Touchdown, baby. Oh, come on. Come on. Touchdown, baby. Touchdown, baby. Celebrate. Signature. Even though Barry Sanders never celebrated a day in his life, we're celebrating here. That was a sick run at the end. Good job, Barry, following his blocks. And just was able to stop it right there. Just a little stop and start. And just, oh, able to break the final tackle and get it in there. Solid. Solid. Barry, buddy, good job. Come on, Spielman. Come on, Spielman. Come on, Spielman. He's going to get in there one of these days. Come on, Christensen. Oh, come on, Christensen. I see you, buddy. Should have caused a fumble. That hit was big. Come on. Oh, that was a good read. Just not the right hole. Come on, Barney. Come on, Barney. God dang it, Barney.
Oh, you're a clown, you are. Why don't you put a red light on your nose and go in the circus?
They scored again. Since it worked so well last time, we're going to do another slip screen with Sanders. Hopefully it works. Oh, he's got someone following him. Oh, that was almost an interception. Not good. That was not good. Randy White. Oh, man, being the legend he is and blocking that up. Damn you, Randy. Macho Man Randy Bastard. Oh, God. Let's stop him on defense.
The punt team now is this one sent away.
What the fuck? Who is my punter? Why is my punter not Yale Larry and it's this guy? God dang it. That's not cool, man. I mean, that was the worst fucking punt I've ever seen in my life. All right. So you got to deal with the hand you're dealt, and we were dealt a fucking 7-2 offside on that play. Are you kidding me? Come on, Lions. Come on. Oh, come on. Dang it. You kidding me? You let Novacek score? Oh, 70 points. I hope we can get 30. Jesus. And I just hope they don't get 70. That would suck. All right, we got to score before halftime, and I think we can. We got Barry Sanders, Calvin Johnson. Let's give Matthew Stafford something to look forward to when he comes in after halftime. We're looking on at Johnson on the outside there. Maybe Cloyce Box. Oh, we got Cloyce Box. Baby. That's how you do it. Put it in a box. Ship it FedEx way. All the way for six. FedEx Air. FedEx Air Award right there. Cloyce Box. Come on. All right. Right there. Is that Charlie Sanders? Come on, Charlie. Touchdown, Charlie. Let's go. Spike it. Ah, I'm Charlie Sanders. Okay, we're back in business. But to tie this sucker up with 16 seconds left to go before halftime. And then Matthew Stafford's about to come in here and just change this game up. What we need is a defense, though. I'm not worried about the offense as much as the defense has just let points go left and right. It's just embarrassing. Especially when you have Dick LeBeau. Come on. That's what we need. We just need Dick LeBeau to retire at halftime, pull Avante Davis, and then join our coaching staff as the defensive coordinator. Or just, you know what, just call defense plays in the huddle, Dick LeBeau. Come on, Dick. We've got two people named Dick on our defense. I just realized that. I don't know why. Holy shit! Are you kidding me, Emmett? Damn it! God bless America. Happy Thanksgiving, everybody. What was that? Are you kidding me?
They ask you how you are, you just have to say that you're fine when you're not really fine, but you just can't get into it because they would never understand.
All right, everybody, it is after halftime. Let's just put that first half behind us, because what the hell was Emmett Smith doing? Oh my god. We're on defense, and... my god!
What you doing there, Bill? Satellite dish trouble?
Nah, I'm just up here to kill myself.
Oh my god. Are you kidding me? Lions defense. Emmett Smith is just dominating us. Instead of putting this on YouTube, I'm gonna have to put it on Pornhub in the BDSM section, because we are absolutely getting dominated by Emmett Smith. Are you kidding me, guys? What the hell was that? All right, we got Matthew Stafford, though. He can bring us back, bring us a little bit of glory here in the second half. All right, another change we made is we got Sims, Billy Sims, at running back. Barry Sanders is going to be our third down back, but Sims is going to be our running back right now. And Billy Sims? Are you kidding me, Billy? Billy, touchdown, Billy Sims. Let's celebrate. Oh my god, 53 yard. What is he doing? Is he gathering his Thanksgiving plate for Thanksgiving dinner? He's having himself a feast. He's eating it up at the Madden turducken. Billy Sims, are you kidding me? All right, come on. Let's get the ball back. Come on. No way. He has 9 rushes, 209 yards. Oh man. Shut down Emmett Smith. That's the priority number one. Numero uno. Stop Emmett Smith at all costs. Let him hurt you through the air. I don't care. We're going to stop Emmett Smith. Oh, we're going to stop Roger Staubach. Ernie Sims. Good job, boy. Good job. Yeah, let's stop him right here. I doubt the run. They've got Tony Dorsett in. I highly doubt the run, but they can still get us. They can still get... Are you kidding? Where...
Let him hurt you through the air.
Where's the defensive back that's supposed to be on him? What the hell? Just decide to go home early for Thanksgiving? I can't be thankful for that. I you're not giving me a lot to be thankful here, defense. All right, we gave it to Billy Sims on the last play on offense, and he scored with us. And we are going to give it to instead Barry Sanders here. Okay, called a run play. I thought it was Billy Sims, but Barry Sanders is going to play for us. Let's go, Barry. I believe in both of them, and that's not going anywhere because Bob Lilly. All right, good job, Bob. All right, we got Billy Sims back out there, and we're going to try another run with Billy. Come on, Billy. Come on, Billy. Okay, Billy. Damn, Billy. Billy's having himself a night. I like it. I love it. I want some more of it. But before we get some more of it, we're going to throw to Johnson, maybe. Johnson. One-on-one, Johnson. Ah. Oh, pass interference. Pass interference. Defense. All right. Oh, what happened? You forgot Mel Renfro. You're playing in the new era of football, where anything and everything that you do to an offense is penalized. Yes, welcome to the Goodell era of football. I know I hit it too. But right now I'm loving it. Call me McDonald's because I'm loving it. Doak Walker getting 8 yards. Let's go. Let's go. Good containment. We're going to do a halfback stretch with Billy Sims, who has just been dominant all night. I've been loving running Billy Sims. Oh, come on, Billy. Come on, Billy. Come on, Billy. Shove him off, Billy. Getting 4 more yards on that total. Damn, Billy. He turned what would have been just terrible loss of yards into 4-yard gain. Okay, Billy. 4th and goal. What the heck is this? We're going to drop kick it into the end zone, even though I accidentally called a fake punt instead of a fake kick. And that's, I was going for the fake field goal and I accidentally called fake punt and I decided to go with it. And Schlesinger couldn't do it. Back on defense, down 2 scores. It's not looking good. They're pushing us around. Oh, come on, though. All right, we'll just get the safety and go 30 to 42. That's all right. We'll just do that. Oh, no. Oh, whew. Spielman. Thanks. Try to score before the end of the third quarter, which I don't think we'll do, but we'll try. Spielman! Fumble! Get it! Get it! Get it! Damn it! Come on, Spielman. Let's go, Spielman. And Mel Gray can return this ball. Jesus, that was a punt. Matt McBryer. Oh! Oh, you thought... Okay, Dan Sanders still got us. We're at the 50. That was a good return. I'll take it. Corner strike. I have not gotten Herman Moore at all in this game, and that's, I don't like that, so we're going to go Herman Moore, probably. Yes, we're going Herman Moore. Herman Moore getting it. All right, good job, Herman. Anyone named Herman, you know automatically is one of the best wide receivers to ever play, of course. All right, Calvin Johnson jailbreak screen. Okay. 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 Okay, Calvin. Okay, Calvin. Let's go, Cal. A guy named Calvin and a guy named Herman. Are you kidding me? We're winning. There's no if, ands, or Hermans about it. We're going to win this game. It all starts right here on this drive, though. We got to score a touchdown. Got to score this touchdown. Right there. Right there. Come on. Come on, Calvin. Come on, Doak. Doak, Herman, and Calvin. And Cloyce. We can't forget about Cloyce. Okay. And like 3 guys named Dick. Are you kidding? I thought that was intercepted. I thought that was intercepted. He got it to Billy? What the f- oh, everybody. We got ourselves a touchdown. Oh my. That was tight.
Tight.
Look at this. Dude. Did Billy steal it from Charles Haley's hands? Oh my. Okay, Billy? Let's get on defense and let's stop Emmett. Oh my god, let's stop Emmett. All right, it starts right here. It starts right here. It starts right here. It starts right here, everybody. Al Baker, you are the man. Let's go. Okay, that's one out of three. Let's get this one. Let's get this one. Oh, pick! Pick! Dick LeBeau! That's Dick LeBeau! Yes! Come one tickle, Bo. Let's go, Dick. Good job. Oh, yes. The legend, Dick LeBeau, does it again. He had. Who says white men can't jump? There you go. That's proof right there. Dick LeBeau. Climbing the ladder, getting up there, getting that pick. Okay, let's get on offense. All right, we're going to have ourselves a little PA in around, fagging around with Calvin Johnson, a little loft pass to Sims or something. That could work. Little floater to Sims, and Sims. Hey, man, you can't do that. That's illegal, boy. Doesn't matter. Billy Sims still caught it. Doesn't change the fact that we're about to tie this bitch up in the fourth with 3:24 left to go. Are you kidding me, Billy Sims? Give Billy Sims the turducken right now. Give him that turkey leg. He deserves it. I am thankful that we have Billy Sims. That probably means they're passing, but still, we gotta watch out for that. Oh, we gotta watch out for this. Oh, come on. Now the other safety blitz. Larry blitzing. Oh, this is scary. Scary Larry. Sack Ezekiel Ansah. You thought you had me. You thought you had me on that on that fake. They're out of field goal range, so they have to punt it. I'm guessing this will probably be a touchback unless he just line drives it out of bounds. Oh, he pooch kicked it. We're going to just... fair catch that. Don't want to risk anything here. Let's go down and let's win this game on this drive. Just try to run clock and score a field goal or touchdown and win this game. Win the first of the Thanksgiving extravaganza bowl games. Let's go down and win ourselves this game. All right, we got ourselves an inside zone split with Billy Sims running the ball. Let's go, Billy. Let's go. Oh, God, Billy, are you kidding? Oh, man. Put him in the hearse right now. Jesus Christ, Bob Lilly. Are you kidding me? You can't just disrespect a man like that. Jeez. Ouch. Third down and one. This is crucial. We have to pick this one up here. Hopefully, we pick the perfect play for this. I'm hoping, as will. We're running Corey Schlesinger. And Corey Schlesinger? Are you kidding me, Corey? Okay. We just needed 1 yard, and he got like 10. All right, Corey. Okay, first down. Give me that first down. Fourth down and one. Are you f***ing kidding me? Doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. We're going to win. We are going to win. I'm going to give him a little time. I want it to be a little bit exciting. So we're going to kick it right here. It's going to give them a second. Maybe. Nope. Doesn't matter. We win. We win with time running off the clock. The Lions win the first game of the annual Thanksgiving Extravaganza Bowl, winning the equivalent of the Super Bowl. You know what? That's better than winning the Super Bowl. That was a really good game. Emmitt Smith just tore us apart, but we were able to fight our way back into it. Billy Sims getting himself the turducken. Don't worry, he gave a piece to Emmitt Smith after the game. They're friends. But Golden Tate had himself the first score of the Thanksgiving extravaganza. And we have one more game to go. We have a double feature today. So don't click away from this video just yet. We are going to play as the Cowboys against the Lions and see what we can do with Emmitt Smith rather than against Emmitt Smith. But we're going to be trying to stop Barry Sanders, which is equally as scary. So I will see you in that game. Let's get into that game and let's see if we can get ourselves another win. This one, 45-42 Lions, as we see them hoist that trophy. Commemorative turducken trophy for the ultimate Thanksgiving extravaganza bowl. Let's go. Let's get into this other game. All right, everybody, we are starting this second game off, and one main difference you are about to witness as we are getting the ball is that we will not be starting Roger Staubach. We're going to... Holy shit! You good, Hayes? Anyway, we are going to be starting Troy Aikman at quarterback. And then in the second half, we will be starting Tony Romo. But other than that, let's get started. We got Emmitt Smith in the backfield. We got the old trio back together. Aikman, Smith, and Michael Irvin. Let's get this thing. Let's get this show on the road. Ah, man. -1 yards with Emmitt Smith. Uh-oh. That's not a good way to start. That was just a fluke. Let's run it one more time with them. See what we can get. We even got Johnston back. We get Bob Hayes coming over the middle. Jason Witten. Imagine if they had Jason Witten too. We get Bob Hayes. who just avoids major destruction, kind of still gets a hit on him, but he's all right. All right, we got Dorsett in the backfield. Aikman about to hand it off to him. He's going to get some good yards. I can feel it. Oh, come on. Just about a first down. Second and two. Got 8 yards. That's pretty good. All right, Dorsett. Dorsett being the first player in NFL history to get a 99-yard rushing touchdown. If you didn't know that, that's a little bit tidbit of NFL history for you. Tony Dorsett coming in big right there. Aikman taking off and running for it. Okay, Aikman. Irvin across the middle. That's definitely a good choice. Oh, shoot. Oh, escapes the sack. Oh, throws it to Irvin. Irvin pulling some moves. Oh, damn it. Why did Yale Larry have to be so good? That was an amazing play. Oh, man. I thought it was good for a second there. I was like, touchdown, baby. But Michael Irvin getting it to the Detroit Lions 9 on that play. That was a big play by Aikman as well. Jesus, Troy. Good job, buddy. Yeah, but I wonder if Alex Karras is betting on any of these games. if you don't get that, it's all right. Oh, right there. Right there. Tony Dorsett. Okay. Tony Dorsett pulling a Michael Jackson. All right. First he did the whip. First he did the whip, then the MJ, and then another whip. All right. Tony Dorsett. He hit the crossbar. Oh, man. Okay, field goal. That should count for points. I'm still under the belief that if you kick a field goal on a kickoff, that should count for at least 1 point. At least. Because that's just crazy. But anyway, like, the team still gets the ball in 25 or whatever, but your team also gets a point. Come on, just think about it. Put it in the comments below what you think on that. And what would you do about it? Out of curiosity, what you guys think on that? Oh, come on. Forget about Barry Sanders. We got to stop Calvin Johnson. Oh, my God. Renfro. Was that Deion Sanders? Deion, was that? God dang it, Deion, was that you? Yes. Oh, Calvin Johnson on Deion Sanders. I'd pay to see that matchup. Boy, did I pay. Did I pay for that matchup? Come on, Hayes. Come on, Bobby Hayes. Come on, Hayes. Okay, pulled Yale Larry. But anyway, these Thanksgiving extravaganza matchups have been very good so far. Both of these games have started out really well. Oh, come on. Come on, man. Emmett. Almost got through. Got 3 yards. Emmett Smith in the flat. Let's see what we got here. Oh, no, we got... Who is that? Was that Hayes? Hayes, what are you doing, Hayes? Oh, Jesus Christ, Dick, Night Train Lane, what are you doing, Hayes? What was Hayes doing? He was just like, oh, let me just stay here for a second. Whoa, what's going on? And then just gets lit up by Night Train Lane. We're on our 5 second and goal. We've got Owens, we've got Irving, we've got a great chance at scoring this in the red zone as we throw to Irving, and Irving gets it with Glim Barney on his back. It does not matter. Troy Aikman to Michael Irving. You cannot break that up as we score here. All right, we are in defense. They don't even have Barry Sanders out on the field. Okay, are you kidding me? All right, let's get in there, though. Oh, they got Herman Moore. They got Herman Moore. Oh, man, they've just got so many offensive weapons. It's crazy. You'd think with the defense we have, it'd be easy to stop them, though, still. But nope. The all-time Thanksgiving Day matchup right here on Strange Voodoo TV. I hope you guys are having yourself a good time. I hope you are enjoying your Thanksgiving as we stop Barry Sanders with DeMarcus Lawrence. Good job, DeMarcus. Stopping him for a 3-yard loss. That is big right there, as we now have him at 3rd and 13. I sincerely hope you guys are having yourself a great Thanksgiving right now as you're watching this. And if you're watching this later, I hope you had a great Thanksgiving, and I hope you're having yourself some good leftovers as Charlie Sanders is... Oh, come on!
What the fuck, Richard?
Seriously, no one wants to tackle?
What the... See, that's the type of... I'm gonna kick your ass.
Anyway, I hope you're having yourself a great Thanksgiving. Let's... let's get on offense. Okay, come on, Bob Hayes. Come on, Hayes. Come on, Hayes. Yale Larry again? God dang it, Yale. We're tossing out to Emmett Smith, who's taking it up. Nice block. Oh, nice cutback. Oh, Jack Christensen was like, no, I'm not having any of that business. All right, we got Terrell Owens one-on-one on the outside, and you better believe we're calling it just a straight fly. Just go. And we're throwing it to him, and he's going to get it. One-handed catch over the line. That's a touchdown, baby. That is a touchdown, baby. 46-yard touchdown on Night Train Lane. Terrell Owens one-handing it. Are you kidding me? Wow. Look at this. Look at, right there, right over Dick Night Train Lane. On the sideline, able to slide it in there. Get it over the goal line for a touchdown. And we are going up 21-14 over the Detroit Lions. And that is how you do it, Troy Aikman to Terrell Owens. Are you kidding me? Wow. And after that absolutely impressive catch, we are on defense. We are in desperate need of stopping them right here.
Go!
What are you doing? What are you doing? Why did he stop rushing the quarterback? He was like, never mind. What the hell was that? He had a straight line that could have been a sack. Oh my God. Come on, Ed Too Tall. Too Tall Jones. Come on, Too Tall. Come on, Too Tall. Get in there, Too Tall. Right, again to Charlie Sanders. The same damn play. That was the same exact damn play. All right, come on. We got DeMarcus Lawrence in there. He's ready. He's ready. Come on. DeMarcus. Oh, okay, Barry. Oh, come on, Barry. Come on, Barry. Good job. Good job, DeMarcus Lawrence. Getting Barry in the backfield. Able to corral him. All right, we need to do this again. We're sending an extra blitzer from the outside. I don't think Bobby Lane's ever seen that before. He's not prepared for that. He hands it off anyway, and we get him. Barry Sanders gotten down in the backfield. Good job, Cliff Harris. Good job, Harris. That's how you do, buddy. Let's hold him to a field goal. At least we'll rush DeMarcus Lawrence right here. Come on, DeMarcus. Come on. Stop him. Stop him. Don't do it. Don't you say first down. Fourth and one. Let's go. All right, we got Emmett Smith on the toss. Come on. Breaking tackles. Oh, come on. Going out of bounds. Okay. All right. Doing the same thing to the other side. Getting some blocks. Getting some good blocks. Oh, come on. Ah. Stood up. Brought down. Still a good play there. Yale Larry. And on another one. All right. The play after the two-minute warning. We're looking at some good routes here. Maybe Bob Hayes over the middle. Yeah. Oh, Bob Hayes breaking some tackles. Okay. After that tight throw, that was almost blocked right there. Almost intercepted, I think. Jeez. But got it through. Ooh, what is this? Is this a Bob Hayes reverse? Yes, it is. Oh, man. They don't know what they've just gotten themselves into. Bob Hayes. Oh, yeah. Come on. No contest. Bob Hayes on the reverse, end around all day, every day, gonna score points all the time. And now we are about to go up 28-17 right before halftime. Let's stop him and try to get this ball back and maybe score yet again. All right, here Bobby Lane is trying to rally his troops. Throwing to Barry Sanders. Oh, come on, Cliff. Good job, Cliff Harris. For points before the half, we can't let him get them. Oh my God! Herman Moore, he's getting up? How the hell is he not paralyzed? My God. Oh, God, dang. Come on, Lawrence. Come on, Lawrence.
Oh. Really, nigga?
Oh, come on. Get in there. No. What the hell was that? Bobby Lane for 17 yards? Come on, guys. I mean, I know Deion Sanders doesn't like to tackle, but jeez. We have the chance to stop him, though. Let's keep him to a field goal yet again. That'd be at least nice. Or a pick! Or not! Are you kidding me? Get your damn hands up! Alright, they're looking pretty good right now. We cannot let this happen. We cannot let this happen. Oh, come on. Come on, DeMarcus Lawrence! Chugga-chugga-choo-choo, baby! That's how you do it, Lawrence. 16 seconds left to go. We got to keep them to a field goal. We can't let them score right here. Harvey Martin. Oh, come on, block it. Ah, oh, Herman Moore on Deion Sanders, and Herman Moore wins. You can't be doing that, Deion. What are you doing? All right, we are on here on defense in the second quarter. Bobby Lane, pick Sean Lee. Sean Lee, almost returned. It got knocked out by Bobby Lane. But Sean Lee with the pick. Let's go, everybody. That was quick. And a change you will notice, actually, is that on offense, we are starting Tony Dorsett as well as Tony Romo in this second half of football. And Dorsett pulling some moves, getting 9 yards right off the bat. Okay. Yeah, we wanted to change it up a little bit in this second half. And we also have Marion Barber as our third down back. And he's coming in right now anyway. We're running the read option. Watch this. Oh, come on. First down. You have to be kidding me. That is a bunch of doggy bag bullshit. Are you kidding? 3rd and inches every single time. You know Romo's gonna get it. Why not? PA end around. Little floater to Tony. I can see it right now as I see Karras right in our face getting a sack. Didn't even let us get anything. I guess we go for the field goal here. Dan Bailey, one of the most accurate kickers ever, and kicks it right through the uprights as we go up 7 on the Detroit Lions. All right. We cannot let them get this 3rd down and 20. They do not. All right, now we are on offense. We are on their 37. We are getting ready. We're going to try to score here with Tony Romo. Tony Romo trying to break a tackle there and get wiped out. Let's try to use Tony Dorsett some more. I like running him. He feels good. Feels good running him. Okay, Tony. First down. Flag. What is it? Holding. Please don't be holding. Face mask. Good job. I mean, bad job, but good job. All right, come on. Oh, fake. Oh, come on, break the tackle. Oh, man, I tried. I did what I was going to try to do with the Lions. I tried to do it with Troy Aikman and the Cowboys, and it just did not happen. I want to make this exciting. Oh, come on. Get through. Don't let Billy Sims get it. Oh, whew. Okay, that was a hit there at the end. Harvey Martin, come on, Harvey. What are you doing, Harvey? Ah, Calvin. Are you kidding? Bobby Lane hasn't thrown a pass that's hit the ground yet today. He's thrown every completion, and the only incompletion, quote unquote, was a completion to me. Are you kidding me? Oh, Leroy Jordan. There's no way. Unblocked. Right in the quarterback's face. Right in Bobby Lane's grill. Man. Come on, White. Are you kidding me? What is Golden Tate, the reincarnation of Gale Sayers, even though he's not dead? What was that? All right, come on, Harvey. Let's go, Harvey. Taking out Bobby Lane. Oh, man. All right, Bobby Lane all alone in the backfield there. No running back. Oh, come on. Are you still? Good job, DeMarcus Lawrence. What the hell was that? We got a team full of people that do not want to tackle today. Calvin Johnson, over 110 yards now. Almost 120 on the day. Okay. Good job. Was that Hollywood hit? No, that was Charles Haley coming in. Good job, Charles. All right, and after holding him to a punt, we are now trying to drive this one. We're on our 31 with 4:37 left to go. We're going to toss it to Dorsett. Dorsett's going to... Oh, man! Oh, Dorsett! Jumping over Jack Christensen. Oh, we got Owens one-on-one again, and we all know what happened last time. That happened. And will it happen again? Oh, he caught it, though. Okay.
He did what?
He caught He got it. Oh, man. For a second there, I wasn't even sure that he got it. All right, where do we go? Where are we going to go? Block for me. That was awkward, but first down, I'll take it. A Tony Romo specialty right there. Awkward runs for first downs. All we really have to do now is just control this game till the end. We pretty much got it in the bag if we can score here too. And I mean a touchdown, not just a dinky little field goal. Let's go up 14 on these suckers. Bam, right there. Woo! Never mind. All right, we got Emmett Smith. And... oh, that was a touchdown. We get the first down, but that looked like it was a touchdown. Somebody challenge that. Come on, Booth. Oh, come on, Booth. You got to challenge that, buddy. Real quick, I did want to look at it. Just Emmett Smith. Oh, man. Just Larry trying to fight off Yale Larry. And... yeah, that wasn't. That was really close, though. Jeez, that's about as close as you can ever get to not scoring a touchdown. All right, Tony Dorsett's got it, though. Tony to Tony, touchdown, and that. That probably is your ball game. Let's stop him. Come on, Harvey. Come on, Harvey. Harvey's coming for you, Bobby. Harvey's coming for you, Bobby. And he gotcha. But not before a first down. 29 seconds. I mean, we have the game in the bag. I just don't want to let them score again. I do not want to let them score again. False start. Taylor Decker, what are you doing, buddy? What the fuck? No. No. What? That was a false start. I didn't even see my guy move. Are you kidding me? I have to replay that one. I have to look at that in editing. Jeez. That was a false fucking start, man. As they score again, Herman Moore. Cliff Harris tried to knock it out at the end there. Was not happening. Oh, man. Are you kidding me? That was a false start, man. All right, let's try to get this onside kick, I guess. All right. Come on. Okay, got it. Dez Bryant. Getting it. Finally catching it. he got the line drive right to him. But anyway, that is the game. We won both special Thanksgiving extravaganza bowl day games. Both teams, we won with the Lions first off with a walk-off field goal. And here we won in convincing fashion with the Cowboys. In both games, it was really, really good games. And I'm just happy to play with these teams. That was fun. A lot of fun playing with these all-time teams. And hit me up in the comments below if you want me to do like a one-off franchise mode with either of these teams or both of these teams and see if we can make a Super Bowl and stuff like that. That might be a fun episode as well. But anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, hit that like button. If you haven't already, hit that subscribe button. We've been growing over these past couple of days, weeks, and this past month, and I'm so thankful for you guys. This is the day especially that I want to say thank you to all of you beautiful, strange people for commenting, liking, subscribing, viewing, just anything you've done. I really appreciate you guys. I'm so thankful for you guys. I hope you guys have a great Thanksgiving. Eat up all you can. Have yourself some turkey, some cranberries, some dressing, all that good stuff. I'm getting hungry just thinking about it. But anyways, guys, as always, I'm Buddy Strange. This is Strange Voodoo TV. Keep it strange, people. I'll see you in the next one. Peace out.